Ho Ka Po, a young police officer, has been given a chance to join the surveillance unit. She is put to test in a bus to study and remember everything. A man in a red sweater and black jacket takes his seat by her side and brings out a book to solve a math game. Ka Po spots a man in eyeglasses sleeping throughout the ride. He suddenly wakes up and realizes that he has been driven past his stop and hurries up to get dropped off at the next stop. When the bus gets to the next stop, the man in glasses gets off. The man in the red sweater also comes out and crosses the road to the other side. Ka Po also gets off the bus and starts following the man in glasses. The man in the red sweater gets on top of a building to survey the surroundings and make sure it's favorable for his team's heist. While Ka Po is following her target, the gang of armed robbers break into a jewelry shop. Quickly, Sean, the man in the red sweater, sets his timer to 3 minutes. The robbers smash the glasses and steal all the jewelry. Soon, the 3 minutes are elapsed and a police officer hears about the robbery. He hides in the corner of the street and informs his colleagues about it. A man in a green jacket sees him and walks towards his direction with a gun in his hand. He walks past him when the robbers get into their cars and leave. Just then, the police arrive and the man in the red sweater leaves. At the restaurant, the man in glasses approaches Ka Po and asks if she is Piggy. He then asks why she has been stalking him. Ka Po becomes speechless. The man introduces himself as Sergeant Wong from the surveillance unit. Ka Po is delighted to meet him, but he wastes no time and begins to question her about every move he made while in the bus and out of the bus. Ka Po passes all but one. She apologizes for not being attentive and asks if it makes her qualified for his team. Sergeant Wong gladly welcomes her into his team. Just then, the news about the robbery reaches them. The Central Intelligence Bureau starts looking through the camera footage to find any information about the robbers. They find Tung suspicious and begin to pursue him. Piggy is introduced to her colleagues and Madam. Madam puts them to work immediately. They are to stalk Tung. The surveillance team steps out to search for Tung. All day long, they see no signs of him. At night, Piggy takes a break to freshen up and on her way, she spots Tung. Piggy quickly informs the team about it and they all move their attention to him. Tung grabs some items and heads towards his house. The surveillance team continues to follow him around without his notice until he gets to his apartment. The next day, Sean and his gang plan another robbery. Later in the day, Tung gets some items from the supermarket. Piggy waits for his arrival at the elevator in his apartment. She gets in with him the moment he arrives and takes note of the floor where he will exit. She joins him in the elevator the next day and intentionally causes a scene when he gets to his floor. Piggy gets out to collect her coins and uses that chance to watch where Tung will be entering. The next day, the surveillance team set out to pursue Tung and the others. The Intelligence Bureau finds out that they have all grouped in a building nearby. The Intelligence Bureau goes to the building and plants a camera beneath their door to watch and listen to their plans. The robbers are planning another heist, and as soon as they leave the building to their targeted location, Sergeant Wong orders one of the surveillance unit members to go pursue them with a motorbike. Sean takes his position and accesses their surroundings to ensure his team won't be caught in the act. He notices some cars parked in their route and calls his team to abort the mission right there. The Intelligence Bureau monitors Sean's every step and communicates it to the surveillance team. While Sergeant Wong and his team pursue Sean, the HIT team also goes after Sean's gang members. The HIT team blocks their way when they find them and a shootout erupts. Sean's team tries to escape after a brief pause by the HIT team and divert their attention to the driver in the car, but it turned out to be a deadly move. 3 out of the 6 get shot and the rest escape successfully. On the other side of the town, Sergeant Wong and Piggy continue to pursue Sean with the help of the Intelligence Bureau. They lead Sergeant Wong and Piggy to the park where Sean arrived a moment ago. The Intelligence Bureau tries reaching out to Sean to track his location, but he takes the battery out of his phone without delay when he notices their plan. Now, they can't get a signal to find him. Sergeant Wong spots Sean as one of the men near the jewelry shop and starts following him. Piggy disguises herself as a pedestrian, takes a picture of his face and sends it to the Intelligence Bureau. Sean on his way gets stopped by a police officer and is asked to show his ID. Piggy sees this and informs the Intelligence Bureau and her team about it. In a burst of a moment, Sean attacks and shoots the officer. Piggy rushes to save the officer. The head at the Intelligence Bureau orders Piggy to continue the pursuit of Sean, but she ignores her commands and tries her best to stop the bleeding, but to no avail. In no time, Sergeant Wong arrives and takes her away from the scene. At the Intelligence Bureau, they dig into Sean's identity and find other crimes he has committed. Later that night, the team receives a new case about a child who was kidnapped after school. Madam addresses the case and asks all of them to stay at the office the whole of the night to work on it. After that, Piggy raises concerns about Sean's case, but Madam reminds her of how she let him escape when she tried saving the police officer. Piggy then apologizes for her unprofessionalism and gets back to work. Meanwhile, on the other part of the town, Sean and his gang break into a jewelry shop. Sean goes to his mom the next day. Piggy positions herself near a phone booth in order to get a clear view of anyone who will be making a call, especially the kidnappers, since they will be calling for a ransom. Sean also visits his mom and dad and tells them about his plan on moving to Vietnam to spend all the money he has made. While Piggy is looking around for any sign of the kidnappers, a man walks to the phone booth and places a call. Immediately, Piggy informs the intelligence bureau to track his call. They do so and confirm that he is one of the kidnappers. In the same moment as Piggy is describing the kidnapper's physical appearance to the intelligence bureau, she spots Sean with his umbrella and a briefcase. Madam tells her to forget about Sean and pursue the kidnapper, but she pays deaf ears to her and goes after Sean. Madam then calls Sergeant Wong to assist Piggy in pursuing Sean. Piggy follows Sean to a cafe where he stopped by to have a drink. While this is happening, the police find the kidnapper's hideout and find the kid held in a cage. The police also find one of the kidnappers at the phone booth and arrest him immediately. At the cafe, Sean notices that Piggy has been following him around most times and approaches her. He asks her if they've met before, but Piggy denies knowing him and says it's her first time seeing him. Sean spots Sergeant Wong outside the cafe and remembers he has been following him around for days. Sean apologizes to Piggy for bothering her, pays for the drink and exits to a different room in the cafe. Sergeant Wong follows him to the room only for him to get stabbed in the neck and left to die. Shortly after, Piggy finds him and tries to stop his bleeding, but he pushes her away, telling her to go after Sean. She finds it hard to leave seeing him in pain and on the verge of dying, but he insists that she leaves. Piggy steps out in the rain and begins to look around for any signs of Sean while Sergeant Wong lies on the floor bleeding to death. Sergeant Wong thereafter calls the intelligence bureau and the surveillance unit. He tells them about his current condition, and Madam motivates him to fight hard because she'll be sending an ambulance to him soon. Madam tries to engage him in a conversation, but he breathes his last and falls flat. Piggy loses control of herself and cries out for Sergeant Wong. She then picks herself up and continues her search. By some miracle, Sergeant Wong regains consciousness and continues talking with Madam. Piggy also spots Sean in the crowd and begins to run after him. Piggy follows Sean to his hideout and informs the police intelligence bureau about his location. Quickly, the hit team arrives and storms the location of Sean and his gang. Sean picks up his briefcase and dashes away for his life. Unexpectedly, a hook rips his throat, but he keeps running. He jumps into a boat nearby and falls flat, gasping for breath, but that he cannot make it. At the end of the movie, we see Sergeant Wong is slowly healing from the injury. Piggy also becomes a professional in the surveillance unit and goes about tracking and monitoring her targets.